Oh man, what's not to love? I love a lot of things. I love the fact that they are so interesting. Like, there's no two black women that are the same. You know, they all are different in their own unique way. You know, from their skin tone to the way their body is structured, you know, from the way they talk, the way they act. It's all, you know, different, but it's all unique and amazing in its own way.
Because you've used them, mm-hmm. black women, as the subject of, your first solo photo.
Exhibit.
There you go.
I named it Queens with a Z. Because I did it like that because I wanted to showcase that any black woman can be considered a queen. And we've kind of gotten away from that mentality lately. You know, unfortunately, like back in the day, you know, we upheld our black women. We looked up to our black women. We held them close. We cherish them, we idolize them, and that's what I wanted to showcase in my first exhibit. But lately, fortunately, everybody wants to be a bad bitch, you know, and we've kind of gotten away from the mentality of, you know, showcasing that black women, you know, pretty dope at the end of it all. You know, they're unapologetic. They don't hold no bars. Like, they, you know, some people can't handle the attitude. I actually love it. You know, it's what makes them unique. Like, some people steer away from it, like, black women, they got too much attitude, blah, blah, blah. It's like, nah. But if once you get past that defense mechanism, you got a pretty good woman by your side.
Mm-hmm. All right, game's up. Okay. All right. So what is something that you would like to share with women? Something that they should know about men?
You're beautiful. You're smart. You're amazing. Don't ever let anybody ever tell you that you're not worthy of love, of affection, of equality, you know, because you come across that a lot, where black women kind of can't really find their place in society because, you know, they have so many stigmas against them. But in all actuality, I feel like one day, black woman's gonna rule and run this nation, and we better get ready for it.
Yes.
You know. And that, you know, there's still good guys out here that still will treat you right. You know, don't look past the squares for those, you know, those moist guys. You know, that's another thing I want you, you know, want black women to know.
Thank you. Appreciate it. Have you ever been in love before?
Once, yes, I was. A couple of times, actually. But I messed up. First one, I was just coming into my own as an artist. And you know, I was, you know, not as attentive to my woman as I should have been. And that kind of came back to bite me when she stepped out, because we were engaged. She stepped out and back to her ex. And most recently, a woman that I really cared about who had basically the same name as me, which is crazy. It's rare. I let my substance abuse get in the way among me also trying to put a show together, take care of my mom who's sick, and also take care of myself. She kind of felt like she was on the back burner, wasn't as attentive and as loving as I should have been. And she left.
What would you say has been the most memorable moment that you've shared with a woman?
I'd have to say, it was not just one woman, it was a few women. My first solo exhibit. A lot of them never really saw their photos after I took them. So for them to see the aftermath of way I showcased them was like one of the best feelings ever. You know, it showcased that they are beautiful. You know, their story was told. And they were immortalized forever. And they had never been shot the way that I shot them, and I was able to showcase that.
Okay. Could you tell us maybe like three essential ways that you need to feel loved and appreciated?
Trust, honesty, and motivation is pretty much the three. Because as any artist, you're gonna have your days where you're gonna be down on yourself, you're going to be feeling like the world is against you. And to be able to have those three essential things lets you know that you can tackle anything. You know, you could take on the world, you know, as long as you got your shorty by your side. You know, as I feel like you can conquer any demon, any obstacle, any bump in the road, and still come out on top. It's like used to against the world, like the Tupac reference, you know, all I got in my life is seeing this me and my girlfriend type thing.
So conversely, what are three essential ways that you show love and appreciation?
Compliments, my art, and just being an overall like support system for any woman that's in my life, you know, whether it's friends or someone that I've worked with, because a lot of them are very insecure. Modeling is, contrary to popular belief, a lot of models are insecure with any and everything about them. So why not be able to showcase that, you know, and showcase them that they're beautiful, that they don't have to be so insecure about their skin tone or their body type, or that they have, you know, a mole on their face. That mole could be sexy to somebody. You know, why not showcase it? Or one of my favorites, tiger stripes. A lot of women hate their tiger stripes. I'm like, yo, showcasing that, having somebody want to buy that, yo, that right there is proof right there that you got the sauce.
What is one piece of advice you wish someone had given you about love?
That shit hurts. No one really went into detail as far as how hurtful it can be, or how You have to be really mad committed to that person. You know, because you're going to go through some stuff that's going to really test not only your relationship but your sanity. You know, you got to be able, if that person, like, one advice that I think that I can give any and everybody that's even in a relationship or thinking about being in a relationship, is married, is you're going to have fights in any relationship. You're going to have battles. But you just got to find that person that you're willing to battle with. You know, because without that, we're all going to be lost. That love is going to be lost. That relationship is going to fall hard. I've had that happen, and I've had to learn that. You know, got to choose that person that you're going to choose to battle with.
So, the redo question.
Mm-hmm.
If you could choose a song.
Oh, the song thing. Yeah.
To describe you.
Mm-hmm.
In essence.
Mm.
Right. What would it be?
I'm gonna have to go old school with this one. It's John Coltrane, In a Sentimental Mood. That's gotta be it. From one of my favorite movies, Love Jones, you know. It describes me, I think, without actually even saying anything. But it just describes me to a T. You know, it's just the way the sax goes, you know, the way the keys hit. Just all the way, all around. It describes who, not only who Roscoe is, but who Christian Davis is.
That's it. No.